So you've heard about board wipe death and you decided you want to take it out on a spin. You like the idea of wrecking broke noobs with the power of pure ETH. Then you look at your wallet and you realize you're one of those broke noobs and your skills, they're questionable. Introducing the Poor Man's Board Wipe, a minimal swag original deck coming in at just two small payments of $23.99. Board wipe nature. The deck works in three stages. One, you're going to buff up your creatures and stuff armor on them. Two, you're going to use the star of the deck, Selena's Insight, to completely wipe your opponent's board. And three, all there's left to do is go face with your now buffed up creature, and that is the game if they haven't rage quit already. All right, so let's go through the deck now. It is built with the new patch in mind, so things like the Pangolin are not included in there. I did include Sudden Bloom, which is getting a nerf, but the nerf is only going down to a +4/+4 instead of +5/+5, so it is still going to be viable even after the patch. All right, let's go through the deck really quickly. So let's go through the steps one by one. Step one, put creatures on board and buff them up. So creatures on board, we have creatures of every curve. We have one drop Marsh Walkers, two Black Jag, three comes the Rabid Bear, four is the Starving Sabertooth, and five is the Brazen Moose. So we got one for every curve. And for our sixth, sorry, we have the Snapping Turtle. This is going to be very situational, whether you need this one or not. But I'm glad that we can let the Snapping Turtle shine. Now that the Pangolin's gone, the Pangolin's little cousin, the Snapping Turtle, well, now this is the one that is actually has the better stats. Okay, so now your creatures on board, you got to buff them up. Well, we have the Moonlight Charm, which is just an absolute dream of a card. It is says on the balance that it's getting a nerf, but the actual nerf might actually help this deck because the new Moonlight Charm is actually going to be an ability instead of a frenzy based. So that is actually going to help us because a lot of times we're not going to be able to get frenzy off. So the new Moonlight Charm is even going to be better for this deck. Okay, next we are going to have Sip of the Spring. That's just an easy buff and mana refresh. We're going to have the Wildfire, which is situational as a buff in case you need to help clear some creatures, maybe prepare for the hunt, and then also buff up whoever's on board. A lot of the time you're going to drop your Wildfire with just your one creature on board, and that's totally fine. All right, next we have the Aspect of the Pangolin, and this one is super vital. You're going to drop three armor onto a creature. Sometimes you're even going to drop both of these onto the same critter. You're going to have just a massive six drop six armor critter, and that's totally fine. The Aspect of the Pangolin is going to make your creature not be able to die when you finally get into the stage three, when you drop your Selena's Insight and completely wipe their board. So Selena's Insight, we have two of them. Basically this is our board clear. And now that you have your buffed up creature, you play the Selena's Insight, which this entire deck was built around, and you're going to destroy all enemy creatures. Now, sometimes you don't need to clear on turn six. Sometimes you don't need to clear at all. So we have some other situational six drop cards here. One, Sudden Bloom. Like I said before, it's going to be nerfed a little bit, but that's totally fine. It will still be good as a +4/+4 instead of a +5/+5. So this is going to be future proof. And this one you're going to use if you need to clear small creatures and you just need to have the overkill. Or if you just want to go face and start getting some damage off, or if you haven't buffed up a creature yet, then drop the Sudden Bloom on it, even if it's not frenzied, just in preparation for the Selena's Insight the following turn. Finally, you're going to have another situational card, the Hunt. We're only running one of them, and this is very situational, and this is just to clear if they have certain cards. It can be used either to clear one big creature or a bunch of little ones, but we only have one of them in there. Unlike normal nature decks, because we have so many other better ways to clear the board, especially once we have a buffed up creature. Finally, we have this situational card, only one of them. It's a one drop hidden Dockside Prowler. And the reason for having this one drop hidden is so that we can keep it away from getting killed by a spell while we're waiting for it to become buffed up with things like Swelling Boon. Or the Moonlight Charm, for example, or the Aspect of the Pangolin. And that's so we can get it down on a turn before we're ready to drop a Selena's Insight in case we have nothing on the board currently. And then it will still give us a chance to clear the enemy board. All right, so let's jump into a few games. This is one of the funnest decks you can play because you never know where this deck is going to take you. There is so much RNG. There is so much buffed up. There's so much armor, and it's just a lot of fun. And honestly, it's going to give you a good shot of versing opponents that are maybe better than you, have better decks than you, and it gives you the opportunity to come back at them and make it more of a level playing field. All right, so we're facing up against the mage here. There can be some troubles with mages just because they have such good spells to deal with our creatures. Also, like, they have the best spell to deal with us, which is, of course, the Ratify. Okay, so what are we looking for here? Stag, I don't mind that. Okay, now that we got these two one drops, I'm actually going to start sifting for... Okay, Aspect of the Pangolin, Marsh Walker. I like it. It's going to be hard for him to deal with. We need something like it would be nice to have like something like a two or a three drop so we can ramp into the Pangolin, but eek. Now I think what I'm actually gonna do is drop the Dockside Prowler. Don't give him a chance to kill it yet. Ooh, nice drop. Nice drop. Okay, that's rough. We do need to get the Marsh Walker down then. And I'm actually going to want to probably pop that ward just in case while we can. You really want to take advantage of your Selena's Mark while you can. Okay, at least we have two critters on board, because if he drops a Bronze Gate here, it's not going to be guaranteed to kill the Dockside Prowler. But if he does drop a Bronze Gate, we're going to have a hard time getting through it. Let's hope it hits the Marsh Walker here. Okay, great. Okay, so now we have the option, what to put our thingy on. We could put the Aspect of the Pangolin on something now. It's a three armor. So if we put it on the Prowler, we can start hitting the Bronze Gate. It's going to take a long time to deal with it, though. The other option is to drop it on the Marsh Walker. And honestly, what I'm liking is maybe even just dropping it on the Starving Sabretooth here. So let's just fill up our board. Send it on back. I mean, the Bronze Gate ability, if it hits two of these creatures, it's not going to kill them. So we have like a pretty good chance of staying alive. And at this point, unless he drops another big structure, we should be doing decent. Yikes. All right, so we've got to keep that Sabretooth alive. Wow. A little bit of RNG never hurt nobody. Okay, so finally, though, he's got the Star Shard in hand. All right, but the thing is, it's fine. We could take it slow. We'll just save up our combo because he can't do damage to face to us, right? So we'll just save up for a nice combo. Like, we can Marsh Walker Aspect of the Pangolin. Pangolin. I don't hate it. But I also don't love it. So we're just going to smack. Heal up. He basically doesn't have much ways to do damage to face for us. So we want to save that pip to get the Snapping Turtle out. Okay, so we got our combo. We got our Selena's Insight. Now we just need a big buff, dude. So what I'm going to do then is drop the Marsh Walker, I believe. And then we can drop the Aspect of the Pangolin on it. Now we got a super buff Marsh Walker. If he decides to ratify that, then he's going to waste his ratify, and then we can drop our Snapping Turtle next turn. So that's the point of that. We also might get lucky and get like a sip of elixir or something. I mean, yeah, this guy's doing no damage against these armored dudes. Two Moonlight Charms. Rough. That's rough. Okay, but he doesn't have a ratify, I don't think. Either way, we need to get a Snapping Turtle out. And if this can last till the end of the turn, then we can Selena's Inside it, and bam, there's our combo. Board is wiped, and we're ready to go. He could also actually... Epiphany this. Okay, so we're good here. But now we can clear the entire board, and then we'll have a card advantage and a board advantage. And two really buff dudes on the board too. It's gonna be really hard for him to deal with. The only thing that could have really killed us there was the Epiphany. But now, I mean, there's no way for him to come back from this. With the Selena's Insight, let's go board wipe. On the Snapping Turtle. You've seen it here first. Okay, that he's not going to be able to have enough mana to get that on turn, which is perfect. That means we're guaranteed to get our Selena's inside off. Let's go. That must feel so bad. That must feel so bad. Oh, and we even... Actually, we're going to take the Bronze Servant so he doesn't... He's not able to clear our Moonlight Charm. Normally, I would take the rune there, but his rune isn't gonna get through our armor, anyways. Okay, so now that we have the Moonlight Charm ready, we can start buffing these guys up, and he's then not gonna have enough damage in hand to get cut through their armor and their health. So the only thing that he could get through is with a Ratify. So basically, as long as he uses both Ratifies, it's game over. He might not even be running two Ratifies, honestly. I think this is the structure deck I made a video about, it looks like, so far. And if that's the case, then I think there's only one Ratify in that deck. Okay. Fine by me. We'll just drop a Moose. We can slow play this because we can... I think I want to hit it with the Moose next turn. Just hit that with the Moose. We can play this really slow. He does not have good game enders. He probably has one Helion Elite. I imagine. I think we could pretty much deal with anything he throws our way. We have a Lightning Strike in hand. We have a Lightning Strike in hand. Why didn't I just Lightning Strike? Why didn't I just Lightning Strike there? I don't know. I could have Lightning Striked and Moonlight Charm. The lights are too bright. Maybe that's it. And there comes the epiphany. Okay, so let's not mess this up again. Lightning. This is what we should have done last turn. At least we have a Moose on board. It's not like we need the armor anyways. Okay, so now we can drop our Moonlight Charm. Then we smack... Mank. Of course, grab the Rune of Fire. And now we start buffing up our Moose. We got an 8-8 Moose. So he's not even going to be able to Epiphany that. Which is nice. Venusian. Coming in clutch. One Star Shard Bolt will actually take out that Marshwalker right now. Oh, we got two Canopy Barrages. What a pickup. Ooh, actually, we're going to have to be a little bit careful here. Okay, there's the luck. Canopy Barrage. And then two smacks to face. We got a 10-10 Moose. I mean, a Ratify's got to come out if he's got it. Yeah, this deck, they probably have no idea what's going to hit them with this deck. It's so random. Something that you have not seen, they have probably not seen in this in their play. So that's what makes it fun. All right, so this is versus a war matchup. This is can be tough because war so fast. So we need to pop off early. Canopy Barrage is going to be nice. Rabid Bear, we don't want the Stag. It's too slow for this matchup. Okay, we have a Dockside Prowler. We have to decide whether or not we're going to go surfing for buffs for it. Because let's think about this. So we actually... No. Moonlight Charm, I like it. So we can turn one Canopy Barrage. If he drops something, turn two Rabid, turn three Moonlight. I like it. Now, I don't want an Enduring Shield to come out turn one. That would not be good. Okay, or just a nothing, and I'll just flip it on back. We got two Moonlight Charms. What a waste. What a waste. All right. I think we just Rabid Bear here because next turn we can Canopy Brush. Which I think was what the play is. Okay. So for sure we going to Canopy Barrage this, I think. Try to get Frenzy. Ooh, Sip from the Spring. Sip from the Spring. Is there a way to have this go off? Okay, if we Canopy Barrage, get lucky, we still have nothing to play. So we got to Sip from the Spring here. And then we can actually just smack that guy. He's going to have to, like, lose his relic and his dude to clear our bear. But might have been better off with the Canopy Barrage. I don't know. I don't think so. I think this was the right play. That's not ideal, though. Okay. We can Canopy here, I guess. He still has three mana to blow. Running two Shield Maidens, pretty random. I mean, he could clear the Sabertooth. I'm just afraid of an Archangel here. But I think if we just Canopy there, we're just dead. So we have to drop the Sabertooth. If he has an Archangel, yeah. Just GG there. What else could he have? Yeah, that'll do it. That'll do it. Okay. I think we just dropped the moose. It's going to take both of his guys to clear it. A nice zombie. Zombie will give us at least one health. He's going to just smack it with his Orcish Elite anyways, so. But then he can at least hit face, so it saves us actually four health, because otherwise, if he wanted to clear the moose, he would go face, moose, and then there, so we would actually lose three health. So if he hits the zombie end moose, then we actually save four health for that because we get a leech back, save three damage to face. I'll take four health. I mean, he's got to clear the moose, right? Which means if he clears the moose, we sudden bloom, clear his Thabian Brawler. He's not going to clear the moose? Okay, that's weird. Yeah, now we can sudden bloom the zombie, clear everything, and get a ton of health back. That was a big mistake, Astro Cowboy. Big mistake. Because our moose is for sure going to hit this guy. Now we can frenzy ourselves. Let's go sudden bloom. Ooh, but it goes to a random. But still. Okay. Still works though, because we can still clear everything. Just don't get the health back. Okay, so of course we're just gonna clear a board here. Actually, I should have went for the Orcish Elite. Would have saved if I wouldn't have been able to finish clearing the Orcish. It would have cleared the zombie. But I mean, we're doing 11 damage, so the odds of it not clearing the Orcish Elite were extremely low. But it could happen. Okay, so this is easy. Selena's Mark, and we clear everything. Oh. And we get a aspect of the pangolin. Oh, wait. Of course that doesn't do anything. But we have twin strike. So because we have the armor, we can just keep smacking there. Flip it back, I guess. What can he do? He can have a carnage. We can lose our moose. But should be fine. We have another moose. I have a moonlight charm. Guess there's no carnage. Okay, so now I guess we can Selena's mark, try to get paw protected. Yeah, we just Selena's mark here. Hit once. And then we can clear everything. There's twin strike. And might as well buff our guy up just because we can. Even a soul survivor is not going to save him here. Yeah, this guy is just too buffed up. So I guess that's another win condition. Just these buffed up guys with armor on them. All right, and that's it for this video. If you want to see a budget nature deck that got 24 wins in Mythic Weekend Ranked, you can see that video right over here. And with that, thanks for watching and have a great day.